In this lesson, we're going to be animating our legend. Okay, so we're right here where we left off last time, and we need to go grab that legend from our project panel. This is one that was not in the infographic split comp, so we'll just select those four layers and drop them on top of everything else. So you can see kind of how that looks. Let's just scale them up a bit, holding shift. And we want this to be just a bit outside of the percentages. Now, it looks like for this to really look nice, we might need to make our pie graph a little bit smaller. So instead of going in and changing the scale of everything individually, which would mess everything up since we have scale keyframes, I'm just going to select everything that has to do with that pie chart animation. Just deselect this. It's going to be all the way back down here to our medium gray cyan solid, and we'll pre-comp it. So hit Control Shift C, and we'll just call this pie graph. And then we come back up here where that is living, hit the S key to bring up the scale. We can just scale that down just to make it fit a little bit better. And it's still readable at 100%. Very readable. You can read that. So that just is going to fit better with that legend animating around it. So I'm just going to scrub through here. Everything still looks great. So now let's go ahead. We'll select our legend, all of those pieces. Let's turn on our continuously rasterized switch just to make all of those clear. And let's get to animating. So I'm going to come back here to where that whales part starts to come on. So right when he starts to say whales is when I want the whales to animate on. And I'm going to do that using a scale animation so they just kind of pop on here. So right about here where he starts to say whales, let's just grab that legend 4. We'll trim it to begin here. So hit Alt open bracket. Then hit the S key to bring up your scale. This is scaled up to 610 and we want to preserve that. So we'll go ahead and set a keyframe, pull that forward a bit, and we'll take this down to 0. Let's just do this over about 10 frames. So I'll hold shift and hit page down. That's going to be my 10 right there. So we'll pull this one back a bit. And this is at 610. We can make this just a little bit longer than 10 frames. So I'm going to pull the 610 forward and we'll add some recoil. So we'll put this at 611, just like that. And let's go ahead and give all these easy ease. So select all your keyframes. We'll go up to animation, keyframe assistant, and choose easy ease. Perfect. Maybe turn on motion blur for these as well, just so they look better as they come in really quickly at the beginning. Zoom in a bit more. That recoil is very difficult to see. So let's move back to this keyframe here. And instead of 611, let's bump that up to 613, just so it's a little more obvious. Much better. Okay, so now let's go ahead and move on to our birds layer. So I'll just hold control and we'll scrub forward to see where that one needs to begin.
Whales make up 1%. Birds are
so right as he says birds, right about here, we'll start that at that point. So let's go ahead and select our legend 3, hit the S key to bring up our scale. And because we have the same scale for this legend as this one, since the scale was changed when it was in Illustrator, we can go ahead and just copy and paste our keyframes from this first legend layer. So go ahead and select those, hit Control C to copy, and we'll select our legend 3 layer and hit Control V to paste. Okay, so let's scrub it and listen.
Whales make up 1%. Birds are 2%.
Move forward a little bit.
Fish are 4%.
So right when he starts to say fish, let's go ahead and bring this one on so we can just paste those same keys. So just select legend 2, hit control V, hit the S key to take a look.
Fish are 43%.
Right where he starts to say mollusks here, we'll hit control V to paste again. And you can hit the S key to bring up your scale.
And mollusks.
Okay, so that looks great. Now let's go ahead and trim those layers so they begin at the same point that their first keyframe is. So I'm just going to put my current time indicator on that first key, hit Alt open bracket to trim, and we'll just go down through the line here, trimming those. Make sure you select the layer you want to trim before you hit the shortcut to trim, or it'll trim it, the one that you had before, just again and pull it back earlier. Perfect. So this is looking really good. Now what I want to do is add some rotation. So I want these to just kind of be rotating around the graph. So let's go ahead and just start with our whales. Just going to come over here to the beginning. We'll hit the R key to bring up that rotation. And let's just do a single rotation, just one time rotation. So we'll go ahead and just set our stopwatch at 0, and we'll pull forward and type in a 1. And let's just see how fast that's going. Now, just typing in a 1 looks like it's making the whales go backwards. So we want to do a negative 1 so that it'll go counterclockwise. So we'll just change that to negative 1. Now they're swimming forward. And it looks a little bit fast, a little bit too much motion blur. So let's go ahead and pull this forward here. Very nice. Let's go ahead and watch this. I'm just going to hit the B key to trim that work area so we're not previewing frames we don't need. And we'll just watch it for the speed.
Whales make up 1%, birds are 2%, fish are 43%, and mollusks make up whales make.
Okay, so it makes sense for the whales to be going the fastest. So from now on, the rest of my layers, I want to go a little bit slower than this. But before I start pasting keyframes from this one to the other pieces, from our whales to our birds, fish, and mollusks, I want to add an expression that's going to continue that rotation animation. So all we have to do is Alt-click our rotation stopwatch. We'll pull this up so you can see what I'm about to click. Choose your expression language menu, go down to property, and go up to loop out cycle. And you don't have to change this to ping pong or anything like that because we just want it to keep going around and around. So now those whales will just keep spinning forever. Okay, so now let's move forward to our birds, and we'll select our whale keyframes for rotation. Hit Control C to copy them. Select our birds and hit control V to paste. Now the birds are going to be spinning too, but I want the birds to go a little bit slower so it doesn't look like they're just all animating with the same keyframe. So we'll hit the U key to bring those up, and let's just pull this forward a few more. Now let's see how many frames are actually in here, and then we'll increase it mathematically for all of our other layers. So just starting right here, I'm going to hold down shift and hit page down. So it's close to 12, so let's just go ahead and bring that forward to 12. And that's a 120. So let's add, let's say, 40 more frames to that. So we'll put that one at 160. So that means we need to move forward 160 frames from here, which is really easy if you just hold shift and hit page down 16 times. Okay, and we'll move that forward. And let's just see what that comparison looks like, if there's enough contrast between the whales and the birds. Very nice. So you can tell that the birds are animating a little more slowly than the whales.
Whales make up 1%, birds are 2%.
Okay, let's do the same thing for our other two layers. So I'll just copy those keys, hit Control C, select the next layer, hit Control V to paste. And we'll hit the U key to bring that up. We want to add 40 frames onto this, so I can actually just start at that second keyframe, hold shift, and hit page down 4 times. And we'll just move that forward there. Then we'll select these, control C, paste them to this layer, control V, hit the U key to bring that up. And this needs to go forward 40 frames, so hold shift, page down 4 times. And perfect. Let's do a RAM preview just to see that move all the way through this animation. Really nice. So you can see how it kind of looks like it's sort of churning. And you can definitely tell a contrast between the whales moving faster than the mollusks. So really, really looking nice.
Whales make up 1%, birds are 2%. Fish are 43%, and mollusks make up 54% of the animals in the reefs. But
okay, so that looks great. I'm really happy with the way that we got that legend to animate in. And our next lesson is going to be how to transition to that statement you heard at the very end where he says, but. So we want to get rid of everything that we see in this comp and move on to that next part of our statement. And we need to do it quickly. So we're going to learn how to do all of that in our next lesson.